Pope Francis once again spoke to a gathering of representatives of worldwide popular movements. He last met with them in Rome this past October, when they discussed social problems like unemployment and a lack of housing and land. On this occasion, the Pope came to them. He delivered the most powerful and wide-ranging speech of his trip.
Los seres humanos y la naturaleza no deben estar al servicio del dinero. Digamos no a una economía de exclusión e inequidad donde el dinero reina en lugar de servir. Esa economía mata, esa economía excluye, esa economía destruye la madre tierra.
He denounced new forms of colonialism that leave entire groups of people as nothing but suppliers, impeding their ability to grow and develop.
El nuevo colonialismo adopta diversas fachadas. A veces es el poder anónimo del ídolo de dinero, corporaciones, prestamistas, algunos tratados denominados de libre comercio y la imposición de medidas de austeridad que siempre ajustan el cinturón de los trabajadores y los pobres.
The Pope said that new and old forms of colonialism must be abandoned. He did not overlook offenses committed by the Church during his condemnation of colonialism. The Pope apologized for crimes committed against local populations during the conquest of America.
Quiero ser muy claro, como lo fue San Juan Pablo II. Pido humildemente perdón, no solo por las ofensas de la propia Iglesia, sino por los crímenes contra los pueblos originarios durante la llamada conquista de América.
At the same time, Pope Francis said it would be unfair to ignore the Christians who also left behind works of human promotion and love among native populations. He also highlighted Latin America's profound Christian identity. The Pope mentioned that these things have happened in other parts of the world as well. Even today, Christians are persecuted.
Eso también debemos denunciarlo. Dentro de esta tercera guerra mundial en cuotas que estamos viviendo, hay una especie, fuerzo a la palabra, una especie de genocidio en marcha que debe cesar.
Pope Francis asked for the crowd to pray for him, but not everyone in attendance was Catholic, so he made a special request for those who do not believe.
Que me piense bien y me mande buena onda. Gracias.